You have a problem. People out there, they just won't act right according to how you'd like them to. So what do you do about it? You can't control all the details of people's lives. You can't control all the details of their activity. There's some blunt tools out there for social engineering, and let's look at the principle underlying them all, which we can blame Hegel for. From Hegel, we get the dialectic between thesis and antithesis. You need this to create lasting social change because you need the polarization. The polarization is how you introduce the charge into the discussion, into society. Thesis is going to be in the general direction you want to make your social change. But you can overshoot. Right, you want the thesis to happen faster, but you can keep pushing new versions of the thesis further in the direction of thesis. Antithesis is the opposition. You can wait for this to grow organically, but that can be kind of slow. What tends to be a bit faster, what can be more effective, is you jumpstart the antithesis. You start planting messages opposing the message you want to advance, but you make them comical. You make them easily ridiculed. And in this way, you can kind of get a jump start on it by promoting both thesis and antithesis. Can't trust that the antithesis that might grow organically could be just way too common sense for most people, so you might as well poison your opposition before it really forms. The more extreme and polarized the discussion these both push, it's never in these polarized discussions about simply changing from status quo to something. It's you have the status quo everyone's living, and antithesis frequently will fake a idealized version of the status quo. Simple, clear, remember them good old days, that great again shit, like that goes into antithesis. But Hegel described this tension between thesis and antithesis in his Phenomenology of Spirit, is what Marx built off of. But before Marx, there were like Hegelian societies. Like there was a big one in St. Louis where people would meet, they talk about change, and they do this under this idea that Hegel introduced of spirit as a collective ideal. It transcends individuals, it transcends humanity alive at any period in history, and it just permeates all of history, binding humanity into one collective, moving from individuals to civilizations to anthills to something more like a single grove of clonal aspens like that one out there in Utah. The necessary mindset to completely buy into Hegelism yourself, according to William James, from his subjective experiences on nitrous oxide, he could only encounter that when he was profoundly intoxicated by the gas. It's not something that comes naturally. It's a part of the brain that handles social shit that is vulnerable to this sort of manipulation. In studies, routinely, there's some 70 to 80% of people alive, however you select the group, will be biased towards following without respect to their own individual interests. Just they want to get along. Let's talk about scale and just how big your campaign needs to be to make effective social change. Really, you don't want to look at individual oppressions. You don't want to look at how many times your messages got out, how many flyers you print. The problem you need to consider is, of all the messages out there, what percent of all messages relates to this polarization you want to promote? It's a lot like music royalties. There's a reason why no one can tell you what Spotify is going to pay you for an individual stream, because Spotify doesn't know until all of the music has been streamed for that reporting period. Then they go through, add them up, figure out how much it owes everybody for all of the music streamed, not necessarily that one individual song. They can't put a price on that. They have earned out of all music. That's the sort of mindset you need to undertake one of these campaigns. Out of everything out there people are being exposed to, because people are forgetful. You need to be repetitive. Whether it's Kanye versus Drake, whether it's Coke versus Pepsi, The thing you need to do to really get one of these going is invest a lot of resources into it. This is not cheap. This is not like an everybody thing. Like, this is a people with a lot of money thing. The Greeks referred to less advanced forms of this phenomenon as sophism. Just that refers generally to arguing for a particular end rather than introducing reason to develop cause for it. It's advancing a particular end without any retreat to reason to justify it. It's a lot better to act from cause. We do this because, not we do this in pursuit of. Another major difference from the time of the Greeks is it used to be that if you didn't like a society, you could go, you could live in the woods, you could retreat, you could go find a different society. But as societies converge to be more and more the same, and every last little bit of wilderness has been cataloged, it's been claimed, it's all owned, you can't just go fuck off to a mountain and say, this is mine. Opportunities to escape whatever insanity might be moving up in your society has been reduced to nil. Please like and subscribe for more dubiously hot takes.